What's up, y'all? Super Cupid Joe, and I'm here to give you my quick spoiler-free thoughts on Mulan, the live-action remake of the 1998 Disney animated classic. You can watch it now on Disney Plus for a fee of $30, or wait till December 4th when it releases for free if you can't find the movie online. This movie has been in development hell since 2010. It was finally supposed to release in March, and then obviously because of COVID, they withheld it. It got a premiere, but it didn't make it to the theaters. They ultimately decided to release it on Disney Plus, which was cool until I saw the price tag. When the Emperor of China issues a decree that one man per family must serve in the Imperial Army to defend the country from northern invaders, Hua Mulan, eldest daughter of an honored warrior, steps in to take the place of her ailing father. Masquerading as a man, Hua Jun, she's tested every step of the way and must harness her inner strength and embrace her true potential and bring honor to her family. Before I go in, I just want people to know that there's been multiple adaptions of the story Mulan before and after the 1998 Disney movie. It's just that's the most well-known and the best version for me. It was the first movie I saw in theaters. The stories are all pretty much the same though. The 1998 movie is obviously the most popular. It was more like westernized, featured the musical numbers, which is not in this movie. Also, Cricket and the very popular talking dragon Mushu, voiced by Eddie Murphy, also not in this movie. He's replaced with a phoenix, and Cricket is the name of a character in the movie. Now, even though this movie is a remake of the 1998 classic, the filmmakers drew inspiration from all the other adaptations from China. The 1998 movie and sequel is the North American versions, and all the other ones are more made for the Chinese audience. All the funny business and Mushu got a negative reception over there, so with this movie, the filmmakers are trying to please different crowds while also putting their own agenda in the film. I think this whole movie should have been in Chinese. They dubbed Jet Li's voice, which was super distracting because I've seen almost every Jet Li movie and I know what he sounds like. They wanted to make this more realistic. They could have had the characters talking their own language. Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, Train to Busan, Parasite, they could have got away with it. There's a lot of nods to the animated film. When you watch it, certain scenes, you'll immediately think of the 1998 movie, but it's not gonna be the happy, like, oh my god, it's that scene. You're gonna have that emotional, like, flashback. It's more gonna be like, oh, that's how they did that. Interesting. The musical score was okay. The action was weird. The editing and cuts made the movie like really weird. It's not a lazy remake, but it's not really that fun. Like, it's not even serious or dark too. It's like somewhere in the middle. There's two villains in the movie. Can't really say anything about them because it would be spoilerish, but I didn't like it. I thought it was stupid. Jet Li has one cool thing to do. Again, I didn't like how they dubbed his voice. The way Donnie Yen plays a different version of Shang instead of being romantically involved. He's Mulan's commander and mentor. Ming Yang and Wayne, who voiced Mulan in the original movie, has a small cameo in this. Ife as Mulan, I like the actress. She's pretty popular in China, though recently she's been in some hot water. As a character with this movie being the remake of the 1998 version, like just more realistic take, she's fine. Like, again, like the action was weird. Like, I liked how it would start off, but then it would like just cut and it'd be done and then move to like the... And again, the editing for this, it wasn't good for me. I like the overall message of the movie, though I've seen it 1,000 times now. Don't be afraid to be yourself. Show your true beauty. Whatever a man can do, a woman can do. Don't hold anything back. It's just this version of Mulan, there's something different about her. I can't say what it is because, again, it's spoilers, but you'll pick it up right away. It just changes things. Overall, I didn't hate the movie, but I wasn't thrilled by it. There was no emotional connections for me or like fan moments. If you like this movie, if you think it's like a 5 out of 5, 10 out of 10, it does the original movie justice. Good for you, not for me. Putting the movie on Disney Plus was a good idea, but again, it's not worth $30. I wouldn't even spend that for like Wonder Woman or Black Widow. If you really wanted me to watch it, drop it by like $10-$15 and then we can talk possibly. If you don't care about the reviews and you really want to see the movie and you're planning on paying for it, like for like a better experience, I'd probably suggest watching this with a group of people. It might change your experience with the movie, especially if the other people have seen the original or like fans like you. If Mushu not being in the movie is a problem for you, you're not gonna hear I'll Make a Man Out of You, it's not in this movie, if that's all you care about, then don't watch the movie because you'll be disappointed. I'll tell you to save your money, find it online, or wait till December 4th when it's free. Let your kids watch the original movie and they don't have to see this movie. I'm giving Mulan a 6 out of 10. It's okay for the general audience, but it could have been an overall better movie. I think we need to hide the remaining Disney movies from the high up executives. I don't want to see any more live action remakes. When I was younger, I thought it was a cool idea, but now with the track history, I'm like, it's okay, let's be done with it. Make some new movies. What's left? Like Pinocchio, Lilo and Stitch. They could do a Frozen, but that's still kind of new. I know they have Cruella coming out next year, Emma Stone. Everything else has been done. What hasn't been done is like all involves like animals and stuff. Those need to be left alone. Just re-release them in like HD quality and that's it. Don't try to make them CGI and stuff. So that's my review for 2020's Mulan. Are you guys gonna watch it, skip, or wait? It's all up to you. Let me know what you guys think about it in the comment section, or you can message me personally. Thank you all for watching this video. If you enjoyed my review, please hit the like and subscribe button. Check out my channel for other content. Be kind to one another. Take care of yourselves inside and out, and I will see you guys next time.
The legend will never die.